Hi, my name is Struan and I'm a scientist at Izon Science, and today I'll be talking to you about performing Zeta Potential measurements on your Exoid. Measuring Zeta Potential requires a pore setup that allows particles to be distinguished based on charge, which not every pore is capable of. Only pores in the 80 to 400 nanometer size range are typically Zeta capable. To request pores capable of Zeta Potential measurements, contact support at izon.com. For today, we're using an NP150 nanopore, and we'll be measuring a mixture of charged and neutral particles. The pore has already been wetted and is ready to begin a size and zeta measurement. Select the size and zeta potential button and fill in the details of your sample. The nanopore zeta value will be automatically filled in if you are using one of the electrolyte options listed here. Select Done to continue. You will now be prompted to run a Zeta calibration. This involves the system measuring a CPC sample with a known surface charge at four different settings for reference. Select OK to start the calibration process. Fill in the details of your calibration particles. The calibration charge will be automatically filled in based on the size of the particles you are using. Click Done to proceed. With your calibration particles loaded, alter the stretch and voltage of the system so that you achieve a baseline current of approximately 140 nanoamps with blockade sizes of at least 0.3 nanoamps, then hit Start Analysis. The software will now run the calibration for Zeta, measuring at your set voltage both with and without pressure applied, then at 80% and 60% of your set voltage at zero pressure. This allows the system to distinguish the impact of the electrostatic forces from the electrophoretic forces. Once your calibration is complete, select Done to proceed. The system will now ask for you to clean the nanopore. Follow the instructions on screen. Remove the calibration sample. Then replace the fluid in the upper fluid cell with fresh measurement electrolyte by reverse pipetting three times. Then replace the fluid with 35 microliters of fresh measurement electrolyte. Insert the pressure nozzle, close the lid, and select OK. Wait for the cleaning process to complete and click OK to continue. Replace the electrolyte in the upper fluid cell with 35 microliters of your sample. Then insert the pressure nozzle, close the lid, and select Done. Press Start Analysis to begin your measurement. The Exoid will take a single measurement of 500 blockades per sample at the highest voltage and with zero pressure applied. Once your sample measurement is complete, select Done and remove the pressure nozzle. Again, you will be prompted to clean the nanopore by reverse pipetting three times. Then replace the fluid with 35 microliters of fresh measurement electrolyte. Insert the pressure nozzle, close the lid, and select OK. Wait for the cleaning process to complete and click OK to continue. The system will now ask if you would like to make one more measurement or if you would like to finish. If you are making multiple measurements, it is recommended that a Zeta calibration should be repeated every 2 to 5 samples to account for any changes to the system over time. Select Finish to return to the home page when you are done measuring samples. Please contact us at support@izon.com for more information or if you have any questions.